smell my crystals. And welcome back to my ASMR channel. I hope you all are doing absolutely amazing and taking care of yourself as best as you can. Today's video is a get ready with me, trying out some new products. Well, just one new product. The other product has been out for a while, but it's new to me. I just got it yesterday, so I am really excited to do my makeup today. I think I'm gonna go for a colorful eye look, and yeah, we'll just go from there. So if you haven't seen my last video, then you might be confused of why my background looks different, why my nails are short, and why I have no rings on. Long story short, I've moved, I'm on a budget now, and my hands are really dry, so I had to take my rings off for just a little bit. But they're almost healed completely. You can kind of see where there was some scarring from them being cracked and stuff, but they're almost done healing, and I should be back to wearing all my rings shortly. I miss them, but I know that it was essential. So we'll get right into the makeup. I'm just gonna be using my Real Techniques sponge and my Fenty Beauty foundation. It's looking a little bit crusty. Oh, well, we can do it while we're doing the makeup, but I realized that I haven't been showing my crystals as much on my channel, and I have all my crystals in a glass container now, just like in my room right over there. And I thought I would just pull some to, the sun's being very variable in my stomach. I thought I would just pull some, especially because I'm going through some big life changes, and I'm sure you are too, or even just the start of a new year brings a lot of uncertainty about what's to come, and yeah, I thought we could just whip out some crystals real quick and send some nurturing, safe, positive energy your way, even if you seem to be thriving. If you are, that's amazing. But there is no harm in sending some extra good vibes your way, just for safe measure. On some concealer real quick. I think because of all the life changes, I'm breaking out like crazy. I don't know if it's the like change in water, because I'm now in a different state and I'm not using well water anymore, or if it's just stress mixed with hormones and stuff like that. But regardless, I'm breaking out. It is what it is. But we're just gonna use some of my Juvia's Place concealer. I have a backup of this, but I'm trying to get every last bit of it. Then again, because I'm on a budget. Good. Oh, by the way, I don't know if you can read my shirt or my sweatshirt, but it says, there's no friend. Wait, what does it say? Friend. Oh, there's no friend quite like a cat. Sorry, I had to read it like through a mirror, so I couldn't read it backwards, but my friend got it for me for Christmas, and she thrifted it, and I really like it. I wasn't able to, oh my gosh, my stomach just keeps making noise, I apologize. I wasn't able to take my cat with me when I went to college, so I am really missing her. I'm going back up to see my family this coming weekend, which I'm really happy about. So I'll get to see her then, but she's just really old, and she needs a lot of attention, and she also cries a lot, so I didn't think it would be ideal if she came with me, unfortunately. Really thinking of getting a kitten or something eventually when I'm here. That is for a future date. So I'm going in with my Charlotte Tilbury powder. I had mentioned this when I first got it, but I wasn't sure how I felt about it. And I'm still not sure how I feel about it. I think I just don't have that great of skin, so my skin is never gonna look like flawless, like it says it will, or like airbrushed. I just have never gotten that effect from this, or any skincare, or like any complexion product, so I will probably just be using like drugstore powders from now on, because I don't see any effect on it. Okay, so one of the downsides, I don't even remember what I was talking about, but one of the downsides of living in a student living is there are a lot of background noises that are gonna occur. So I apologize. Then, so I am not going to be the one to say, hey, stop, because I'm filming an ASMR video, but it's just not me. I would never do that. What I will do, though, is do some crystal tapping. This is a citrine point. This is one of my favorites because it's probably the biggest one that I own. And citrine, I really enjoy. So citrine is supposed to emit confidence, protection, clear quartz that is good for protecting you from negative energy. This is also a type of point, just a little bit rigid at the end, but still beautiful. We have some blue lace agate, a nice tumbled smooth one. You can see all the layers in it, in the multiple dimensions of the blue. It's almost purple at this point, but like a light periwinkle. And then we have our carnelian, our tumbled carnelian. It's this nice red color, and just make some noise with that. What was I talking about? Oh, yes, the Charlotte Tilbury powder. So yes, if you have great skin, I think your face is already probably flawless, and it's gonna look flawless with this. If you don't have great skin, like me, it might not live up to the hype for you. At least that's what it did for me. I just don't see a huge difference in regards to making my skin look flawless. But nonetheless, I have a newer product for me. This product has been out for a while, but it's the Jack Dean Cosmetics Rouge Romance in Rouge Affair. So this is Jaclyn Hills. If you know her from YouTube, this is her makeup line. She's had it for like a few years now, and it's a matte blush palette. People walk by my window all the time, and I'm on the first floor, so they can see me since I have my red blinds open, and I just don't know how I feel. But yeah, I actually had been wanting this palette for a while, but it was $45, and I had it in my cart, like, a while ago. Probably this was, like, almost a year ago. I had it in my cart. I was gonna check out. There's two different versions of it. There's this Rouge Affair, and then there's, like, a second palette with different colors. And, it's $45, and I didn't do it, but I had really been wanting these, this blush palette, because I didn't own a blush palette, and I didn't even own that many blushes, at the time. I ended up getting, like, a few single blushes, and then that, like, satisfied my blush need or want or desire. But then I stopped in at TJ Maxx yesterday to look at some things that I was gonna need for my apartment. I ended up getting a trash can for $6, balling on a budget. But I stopped at the makeup section, and they had this for $10, for $9.99, and it retails for $45. It says like compare at 13, but like when I looked it up on Ulta, it was still on there for $45, so I don't know why it was like that cheap, but I'm hoping this is the real deal, and if I could get it for $10 instead of $45, you know I'm gonna do that. So it's Rouge Affair. And it's the Rouge Romance. And so this has, I believe it has 6 blushes inside. We will find out shortly enough, but I really do like the packaging. It reminds me, well, her whole collection of this was like Victorian era, you know, with the like really bright blush. So I think she really did a play on that, and in her like marketing ads and stuff like that, it was kind of like very bright blush. I think she even had like Victorian style outfits on her models and stuff like that, if I remember correctly. But we will open her up. I checked when I was at TJ Maxx to make sure it wasn't broken or anything, and it wasn't. So this is the palette. I think they are absolutely stunning. The pan sizes are huge, and it's still like it has the protective covering on it. So I'll go ahead and the mirror also has a protective covering, so I'll go ahead and peel that off. Here, I'll try to do it so you guys can see it. That's stunning, and the fact that I got it for $10, if it's fake, I don't even care. Okay, so I think when I was watching her like YouTube tutorial about this, or like just her introduction of the product, she mixed a bunch of colors, so I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna probably mix these three, and then maybe this one, this Forever shade. It's a little bit too bright for what I want to do right now. I'm sure these can be used as eyeshadows too. Again, the pan sizes are huge. And this one is a little bit too cool toned right now, but we'll see. But yeah, definitely I'll probably mix these four together. But there's a lot of different like color combos I could make with these. And see how it looks. Just going in with the light hand. Gonna get the nose. And go in on the other cheek. Seems a little bit too bright right now. Let me see if I can shut the blinds a little. It is midday, so it is what it is. But yeah, this blush is super cute. And I really enjoy it. So that was the first new product that I got, and then we're gonna go back in with some of my regulars. So we're gonna go in with some highlight. This is the Becca highlighter, and I believe this is Champagne Pop, but I think it was discontinued, or another company took over and continued making it. But I know Becca did go out of business, I think it was last year. sort of glare. Still trying to get my setup where I want it to be. Where's that coming from? Oh, is it from my mirror? No. Is it this? Where is that glare coming from? Oh, it's this. Okay, I think we're good now, but there are definitely growing pains with moving into a new place because you don't know the environment. Anyway, I'm gonna try this new lip liner out. I have other lip liners from LA Girl, but I've never tried this this color out. Or maybe I have. Actually, we're gonna just use my regular color. That one seemed a little bit too gold toned. Right now, this is definitely more of a nude. And I'm literally only going out to pick up some hangers and something else for my apartment. And then get gas because I have scholarship essays to write for my scholarship application. So I will be staying in and working diligently. My classes start tomorrow, so I only have one class tomorrow in the morning, which is good. So I can probably have the rest of the day to probably go to the science center and see if I can start doing anything there with my research. Ahead and do my bowl rounds, and then the fun part with my eyeshadow. So I didn't even know that there was a new JV's Place palette out. I know brands come out all the time with new things, and I just have not been keeping up, especially because I already have a ton of makeup and I was trying to conservative with the amount of makeup that I buy. However, my old coworker gave me an Ulta gift card when it was my last day. So, and it was $100 gift card. I decided to pick up a new palette, and I didn't even know that this was out until I went to Ulta yesterday. I had to pick up like a skincare tool, so I thought, oh, I'm just gonna pop in. This Ulta was huge. It was twice the size of the Ulta at my old town that I lived in. Oh my goodness. So I was in there for like a good 30 minutes just seeing everything that they had. They had a lot of brands that my previous Ulta didn't even have. So I was super excited. But I was just walking along, and my old Ulta has the brand GRWM place there, but they didn't have nearly as much items as they did at this one. So I guess this is a new palette. This GRWM place, Garden of GRWM. Oh my gosh. It was, so they had it on display so you could see like the color story and everything. So I like walked by and I saw like the palette. So, I need scissors. But to be in my tracks just by the box. I think you already know what types of colors there's going to be in there. And if you know me, you know that pastels are my favorite, my absolute favorite, to wear, to look at, to decorate with, anything. So I was standing there for like a good 5 minutes, and a mother and daughter walk up, and they grab one of them because the daughter wanted it. She was saying that she got that palette for her friend for Christmas, and her friend really loves it, so then she came to get it as well. And after they took one of them, there was only one left. So I was like, oh my gosh, I don't know what I should do. And I was like, you know, you have a gift card, just like treat yourself, you know. So, and this was before I found that blush palette, so I was like, you know what, I'll just treat myself and I'll go ahead and purchase it. So we were like in line at the checkout. She was like, oh, you picked it up. And I'm like, yes. So both of us walked out of there with this palette. But it was $25 for, I forget how many are in there. I think it's 12. We'll find out. Really beautiful palette. I think the box is really cute. I'm actually gonna save it so that it can live in the box. My stomach will not stop today. I'm so sorry. Comes in this nice bubble. Lipstick or something. I thought I was bleeding. Okay. Okay. Open. So the outside is just like the box. We have this beautiful lady with green eyes and flowers, roses and hibiscus flowers in her hair. She's wearing neck rings, and there are also some brown butterflies in her hair as well. So this is the back. And the big reveal. So this is, this is what the inside looks like. A lot of pinks and purples and greens. So when I was talking to the girl that had gotten it for her friend already, she said that the shimmers, and the glitter shades are absolutely stunning. So we have to try them out. Let me see if I can put the shades up and get a good like sunlight few of them, just for a little bit. There we go. Aren't they just like absolutely stunning? I love it so much. We're gonna start out with a little blending brush and go into gardenia. And then this is just gonna be like a base color all over the lid. Just a nice neutral base color. Nice, nice. It's like a very light peach. Then next, we're gonna go in to peony. So I noticed that you can kind of make an entire look with each column. So you have your yellow column, your like teal blue green column, your pink column, and your purple lavender column. So you can kind of make a full look with each column. You could probably make I don't know about the rose, but I'm just gonna go into the shade of peony. It's this nice pink color. And I'm gonna put that in the crease. See how the pigment is. Okay. So far, so good. I do enjoy that. And then let's see how Blossom looks. So Blossom is this color right here. It's like a copper shimmer, and it looks like it has pink like reflex in it. So let's go ahead and test that out. Oh yeah, it's really nice. It does look more pinky on the lid than in the pan, I would say, because of that pink reflex. Really nice. I'm gonna just swatch a few of the shimmers just to show you and to just see for myself how they do. So we'll do Best Buds. That's what it looks like. Okay, that's really nice. Then we have Flower Petals, which is this nice lighter green. Oh, that's really pretty. Oh yeah, super nice. And then let's go into Money Tree, which is this more teal version of this color here. All really pretty colors. And then again, we have like these purple ones over here, but I don't have enough hands, so I'll do my pinky on Purple Orchid here. That's a really pretty one. They all seem really great. wash my hands real quick, and then I will put a pop of color on my lower lash line, and then I'll show you the new eyeliner that I got. Okay, so I have my little itsy bitsy brush that I'm just gonna spray, make it a little bit damp, and then I think I'm gonna go in to, and then I think I'm gonna go in to flower petals right here. This green shade I think would be nice. So let's just dip in a little bit of that and go right underneath the lash line. Oh yeah, I really like this. Okay, and then we'll do the other eye. Rewet my brush. This is gonna be all that I do to my eyes. Oh, so let's use this new liquid liner that I got. It's the ColourPop BFF liquid liner in Grande, which is just a brown. I wanted to try it out and see how brown would look instead of a black. So this is what the component looks like, and then it's just a felt tip liner, nice and precise. So let's see how it goes. Nice and easy to apply. I think brown looks really nice and light and a little bit more everyday looking rather than black. Let's do the other eye. Actually, this is the hardest for me. A little Q-tip action I can't fix, but overall I think the brown looks really nice, especially with this look. I'll be right back, just need to clean this up. Okay, that took way longer than it needed to take, and it didn't even turn out exactly how I wanted, but nonetheless, we're going to add a bit of lip gloss and mascara and call it a day. This is the Fenty Beauty Gloss Balm in Fussy. And lastly, we'll put on some mascara. Look. I was gonna take my hair out of these clips. I have them in just to keep my bangs out of my face, but I kind of like them, so I'm gonna keep them in. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it was kind of a long one, so I hope you enjoyed that aspect and you found relaxation from this video. And I'll see you very shortly in my next one. Good night, my crystals. Good night. Good night. Connect.